ऑफ आई एम तरंग कुमार गोनवाल असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सेंट एंड्रयूज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट गुड़गांव द फॉलोइंग वीडियो इज प्रिपेयर्ड एज पर द सिलेबस एंड कोर्स आउटलाइन ऑफ महर्षि दयानंद यूनिवर्सिटी हाउएवर देर आर मोस्टली जनरल टॉपिक्स विच कवर द वर्किंग एंड थियोरेटिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग फॉर बेस्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड कॉन्सेप्चुलाइजिंग क्लियरली प्लीज डू नॉट स्किप द वीडियो एंड वॉच टिल एंड एट द एंड ऑफ ईच टॉपिक एंड ईच सेक्शन we will be discussing about the related important questions feasibility and application let's start the video
hello students hello everyone welcome back to the channel in this session we'll continue with the subject design of concrete structures which is in fourth semester of Maharishi Dayanand University and we have been discussing about design of short columns and in this session we'll discuss about IS code method for design of columns which are under axial load and biaxial bending so IS 456 recommends the following simplified method based on Bresler's formulation for the design of biaxially loaded columns the relationship between mu x z and mu y z for a particular value of pu is equal to pu z which is expressed in non-dimensional form is mux upon mux1 raised to the power alpha to the power n plus muy upon muy1 this expression also raised to the power alpha to the power n and this and the sum of these two expressions should be less than or equal to 1 where mux and muy are moments about x and y axis due to design loads and alpha to the power n is related to pu upon pu z where the value of pu z is given by this formula 0.45 fck ac plus 0.75 fy asc and in terms of gross area it can be written in this form 0.45 ag plus 0.75 fy minus 0.45 fck multiplied by asc where AG is the gross area of the section ASC is total area of steel in the section the values of MU XZ MU YZ MU X1 and MU Y1 are explained already here these are moments alpha to the power n is well is equal to 1 when the value of PU upon PUZ is less than equal to 0.2 the value of alpha to the power n is equal to 0.67 plus 1.67 multiplied by pu upon puz when the value is 0.2 when the value of pu upon puz is greater than 0.2 but less than 0.8 and the value of pu upon puz is greater than or equal to 0.8 then the value of alpha to the power n is 2.0 now we'll do one more numerical on the same type so the question goes like this design the reinforcement to be provided in the short column which is subjected to pu is equal to 2000 kilonewton mux is equal to 130 kilonewton meter which is about the major principal axis and muy is equal to 120 kilonewton meter which is about the minor principal axis unsupported length of the column is 3.2 meter width is given as b is equal to 400 mm and depth capital D is equal to 500 mm we have to use m25 grade of concrete and fe415 grade of steel for the design purpose so the first step is to verify eccentricities so we are given with l as 3.2 meter which converts to 3200 mm B is 400 mm and capital D is 500 mm. So the minimum eccentricities are given by this formula EX minimum. So this value is greater of 3200 divided by 500. This is L. L upon capital D plus B upon 30. And this value should be or 20. So we will take greater of this expression or this expression. So this expression comes out to be 19.73. So we'll take greater value, that is 20. So 20 is adopted here. And in case of EY minimum, we'll take greater of this expression or 20. So this expression comes out to be 23.07. So we'll consider 23.07. So from PU, which is 2000 kilonewton meter, MUX is 130 kilonewton meter, and MUY is 120 kilonewton meter. We have been given this in the question itself. So we have the value of EX is equal to MUX upon PU. So MUX is 130. And when we convert both in the homogeneous form in the same dimension, so it is 130 into 10 to the power 6. And PU is 2000 multiplied by 10 to the power 3. Now it has been converted into Newton. Millimeter, this value, and this is in Newton only. So it comes out to be 65 mm. Similarly, EY is given by MUY upon PU. So it is MUY is 120 kilonewton meter. So it becomes 120 into 10 to the power 6 Newton millimeter, which is divided by 2000 into 10 to the power 3 Newton, which is 60 mm. The values of EX and EY are greater than EX minimum and EY minimum respectively. So we'll assume a trial section which includes the reinforcement. So we have the value of BS 400 mm and TS 500 mm. For reinforcement, MU is given by 1.15 multiplied by MU square, M square UX plus M square UY, and it becomes 203.456 kilonewton meter. So this value, if we put in all the values here, the value becomes 203.456 kilonewton meter. Now we have to find the value of PU upon FCKBD. So all the values are known. So this value comes out to be 0.4. And next we have to find the value of MU upon FCKBD square. So this value MU came out to be 203.456. And FCK B and D value are given in the question itself. So this value comes out to be 0.0814. So we'll assume the value of D dash is 60 mm. And we have D dash upon D as 0.12. D dash is 60, just assume. And capital D is given as 500 mm. So from chart 44 and 45 of code, the value of P upon FCK is interpolated as 0.06. So P upon FCK ki value ko interpolate karke 0.06 bol diya gaya. Thus P is given by 0.06 multiplied by 25. So this is the percentage of steel, 0.06. is equal to 1.5%. So ये value 1.5% आ जाते हैं, giving ASC as 3000 mm square. तो gross area निकाल लेंगे उससे, area of steel मिल जाएगा. तो यहाँ से जब हम 1.5 को मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, 1.5 इनटू 400 इनटू 500, 1.5%. तो हमें यहाँ पे 3000 mm मिल जाएगा, 3000 mm स्क्वायर. क्योंकि हमें एरिया ऑफ रीइंफोर्समेंट मिल चुका है, सो वी विल प्रोवाइड 12 नंबर बार्स ऑफ 20 mm डाया. सो दिस गिव्स एन एक्चुअल एरिया ऑफ 3769 mm स्क्वायर. तो इस रिइंफोर्समेंट के एरिया के हिसाब से द एक्चुअल पी प्रोवाइडेड वुड बी 1.8845%. सो द न्यू वैल्यू ऑफ पी अपॉन एफ सी के बिकम्स 0.07538. तो 0.06 से बढ़ के 0.075 हो गई है. Next step is to determine MUX1 and MUY1. We have the value of PU upon FCK BD as 0.4 and P upon FCK as 0.07538 as we found here. Now we get MUX1 upon FCK BD square from chart corresponding to D dash is equals to 58 mm. क्लोजेस्ट वैल्यू ये है डी डैश की 58 mm. तो एमयू एक्स वन अपॉन एफ सी के बी डी स्क्वायर की वैल्यू चार्ट से ले लेंगे जो कि डी डैश के लिए डी डैश की वैल्यू 58 के कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग वैल्यू है. सो दिस गिव्स डी डैश अपॉन डी एज 0.116. इफ वी इंटरपोलेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ चार्ट 44 एंड 45, तो इन चार्ट से वैल्यू इंटरपोलेट करके वी गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ एमयू एक्स वन अपॉन एफ सी के बी डी स्क्वायर 0.09044. सो पुटिंग ऑल द वैल्यूज हियर विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एमयू एक्स वन. सो एमयू एक्स वन बिकम्स 0.0944 दिस होल एक्सप्रेशन. And if we transpose FCK BD square to right hand side, this will get multiplied to its expression. So this becomes 0.0944 multiplied by 25. This is FCK, which is multiplied by D, and this is D square is equal to 226.1 kilonewton meter. Similarly for MUX1. We have D dash upon B ratio, so this time it becomes 58 upon 400 is equal to 0.145, and in the similar manner we'll get the value of MU by 1 as 0.0858. So this value has been taken from chart 44 and 45, which is multiplied by FCK, multiplied by B square, multiplied by D. And this comes out to be 171.6 kilonewton meter. As MUX1 and MUY1 are significantly greater than MUX and MUY, we need not to redesign the section. So ये काफी safe limits में है. तो MUX1 की value अभी अब देखा हमने और MUY1 की value भी MUX और MUY दोनों से ज्यादा है, इसलिए section को redesign करने की जरूरत नहीं है. Now we'll determine the value of PUZ and alpha to the power n. We have PUZ in this expression. ये अभी हमने ऊपर देखा था PUZ के लिए formula 0.45 FCK BD. ये हमें यहाँ पे expressions रख दिए हैं यहाँ पे plus 0.75 FY minus 0.45 FCK and this is multiplied by 3769. और ये वैल्यू है एरिया ऑफ स्टील अंडर एरिया ऑफ स्टील. सो दिस इज 3380.7 किलोन्यूटन. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ पी यू जेड. नाउ द वैल्यू ऑफ अल्फा टू द पावर एन इज ऑब्टेंड फॉर द रिलेशन पी यू अपॉन पी यू जेड. तो जो भी पी यू अपॉन पी यू जेड की वैल्यू होगी, पी यू इज 2000 एंड पी यू जेड इज 3380.7. सो दिस वैल्यू कम्स आउट टू बी 0.5916. सो अभी हमने ये वैल्यू निकालने के बाद देखा कि पी यू अपॉन पी यू जेड की जो वैल्यू है वो 0.2 और 0.8 के केस में यूज कर रहे हैं. सो हम सेकंड वाला फॉर्मूला यूज करेंगे विच गिव्स द वैल्यू ऑफ अल्फा टू द पावर एन एज 0.67 प्लस 1.67 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय पी यू अपॉन पी यू जेड एंड दिस वैल्यू कम्स आउट टू बी 1.658. सो we'll put the values of MUX, MUY1, MUY and MUY1, also the value of alpha to the power n in the equation above to check the adequacy of the section. So we'll put all these values in this equation. In this equation, this is equation 5. So we'll put all these values in this equation. So substituting the values, we get 130 upon 226.1 raised to the power 1.658 plus 120 upon 171.6 and this is raised to the power 1.658. And the value comes out to be 0.9521, which is less than 1. So the design is safe. Now, so next step is to design transverse reinforcement. As we have already discussed, as per clause 26.5.3.2C of IS 456, the diameter of lateral tri should be greater than 20 by 4 mm dia. We'll provide 8 mm dia. So because this value comes out to be 5 mm, so we'll provide 8 mm dia following the arrangement shown in figure this, and the spacing of lateral tie is the least of lateral tie ka nikalne ke liye again same formula. This value is B. So this is the least lateral dimension of column. This value is 320, which is 16 times the dia of longitudinal reinforcement bar. So 16 times of 20 is 320, and third value is 300 mm. So hame in tino values ka ke least se zyada nahi hona chahiye. The spacing of lateral tie should be less than the least of these three values. So in tino mein se bhi jo kam jo sabse kam value 300 और इससे थोड़ा सा हम कम 250 mm सेंटर बाय सेंटर स्पेसिंग ले लेंगे. सो अकॉर्डिंगली वी विल प्रोवाइड 8 mm डाया 8 टाइज अल्टरनेटिवली एट 250 mm सेंटर टू सेंटर स्पेसिंग व्हिच इज गिवन इन दिस फिगर. सो दिस इज हाउ आवर रिइंफोर्समेंट डिटेलिंग्स लुक लाइक. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ डी डैश व्हिच इज कवर व्हिच वी डिस्कस्ड एंड दीस आर 12 20 mm डाया बार्स 3 हियर 3 3 3. So this total becomes 12 20 mm dia bars. The area of steel is 3769 mm square and percentage accordingly is 1.8845%. this is greater dimension, this is least lateral dimension, for which is 400, and this is 500 mm. These are alternate ties which are 8 mm in dia and spaced at 250 mm center to center on alternate basis, and likewise. So this was all about short columns. Now we'll move to another topic, which is slender or long columns. So if columns have both values, that is LEX upon B and LEY upon B less than 12, agar in dono ki value 12 se kam aati hai, then they are designated as short columns and otherwise they are slender. Agar value isse zyada aa jati hai, well in dono ki values 12 se kam nahi hoti, to us case mein ye sab slender ya fir long column ho jate hain. Where LEX and LEY are the effective lengths with respect to major and minor axes, जैसा कि हम लोग डिस्कस कर चुके हैं, एंड डी एंड बी आर डेप्थ एंड विड्थ ऑफ रेक्टेंगुलर कॉलम रिस्पेक्टिवली. सो दिस इज द एनालिसिस ऑफ स्लेंडर कॉलम. द डिजाइन ऑफ slender compression members shall be based on the forces and the moments determined from an analysis of the structure, including the effect of deflection on moments and forces. To jo slender compression member, jo slender columns hai, inka jo design hai, ye forces aur jo external moments, external forces aur moments ke basis pe unko determine karke unke basis pe analyze karna zaruri hai. जिसमें कि हम डिफ्लेक्शन का और मोमेंट का फोर्सेस का सबका इफेक्ट कंसिडर करेंगे. When the effect of deflections are not taken into account in the analysis, additional moment, which is given in clause 39.7.1 of IS 456, shall be taken into account in the appropriate direction. अगर हम deflections नहीं consider कर पाते हैं, तो हम additional moment consider करेंगे, जो कि clause 39.7.1 IS 456 में दिए हुए, ताकि हम उसको compensate कर सकें. इस केस में the additional moments M and My, they shall be calculated by following formula. तो x minor axis पे ये और major पे ये formula होना चाहिए. So MAX is given by PU D upon 2000 and this is multiplied by LEX upon D square and MAY is PU B upon 2000 multiplied by LEY upon B whole square, where PU is axial load on the member. LEX is effective length in respect of major axis. LEY is effective length in respect of minor axis. B is depth of cross section at right angles to the major axis and B is width of the member. The values given by equation as we discussed in clause 39.7.1 of IS 456 may be multiplied by following factor. So, jo values milengi hame moments ki उनको हम इन फैक्टर्स से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे. अगर PU की वैल्यू ग्रेटर देन है PU BX से, देन KX becomes KS is then KAX is equal to PUZ minus PU upon PUZ minus PUBX. And if PU is greater than PUBY, then KAY is equal to PUZ minus PU upon PUZ minus PUBY. And with the condition that KAX and KAY should be less than equal to 1. So, हर केस में KAY और KAX की वैल्यू एक से बराबर हो या उसके कम उससे कम होगी. And where PU is axial load on compression member. PUZ is given by 0.45 FCK AC plus 0.75 FY AST. The same formula. PUBX and PUBY are axial loads with respect to major and minor axis respectively. Corresponding to the condition of maximum compressive strain of 0.0035 in concrete and tensile strain of 0.002 in outermost layer of tension steel. So this was about the design and analysis of slender columns. And in the next session, we'll do a numerical on slender columns. Till then, I hope you guys will keep on studying. Take care of yourself. Have a great time. Thank you.
I hope you guys could understand and correlate the topics taught in today's session. If there is any query or subject matter issue, feel free to mail me at the given email ID. Live discussion sessions could also be used for discussion of doubts. Thank you.